Cascada Cafetero in Popayan, Colombia. With these videos, I'm doing what I can for the evolution of human consciousness, and I would appreciate your help to disseminate this important information. Please subscribe and receive the latest videos. Thank you. Truth exists whether we believe in it or not. Unfortunately, the satanic belief system has infiltrated into the consciousness of most people, and it is therefore popular to believe that there is your truth and my truth, and that you have the right to believe what you believe, and I have the right to believe what I believe. This belief is, however, creating complete chaos. If we want to evolve in consciousness, we must first understand that truth is the prerequisite for freedom, peace, and order. If we continue to hold on to opinions and beliefs, we will simply continue to create chaos, which is internal disorder and war, which will then manifest itself as external disorder and war, such as the one we are experiencing right now with COVID-19. Order, harmony, and peace are always based in truth. Our work as human beings is to refine our perceptions as close to the truth as possible. This is what evolution of consciousness is. We must learn to see the truth and learn to look at reality from different perspectives. In order to do this, we must first see the truth of who we are. We must recognize reality and realize that we live in the world of illusion. Learning how to face the truth in a world full of lies is a real challenge. The first question must be, am I lying to myself? And who is the I that is lying to myself? The second question is, am I holding on to positive lie because it makes me feel good? The mental ego is the I, the false self that I believe is me. The ego exists only with the physical body, and it is the one that dies with the death of this physical body. The real me is the soul. The soul is the individualized spirit, and therefore it is eternal. It cannot possibly die. When the physical body dies, the soul moves on and eventually creates itself a new vehicle, a new body, in order to continue its evolution of consciousness. Therefore, if the real me, the soul me, is eternal, then why would I be afraid of death? Ego, on the other hand, is most definitely afraid of death because it only exists with this specific physical body. Ego, I, is the one that is constantly lying to me because it wants to convince itself that everything is going to be okay. Ego is extremely afraid of change, any change, and this is why ego mind will lie to me and manipulate me in any way it can, just so that he can maintain status quo. Ego is afraid to look at reality for what it truly is. Most people will not look at the truth because they have profound insecurities. In other words, their ego is so insecure that they develop this external structure of security, a bubble of fantasy, a bubble of positive lies that they tell themselves just in order to maintain their illusionary world alive as long as possible. Now, with coronavirus, most people cannot admit that a real threat is not happening. This non-threat, this lie, is being used to strip all of our rights and freedom simply because most people just refuse to see the truth. Most people are so terrified that they rather hold on to the positive lie and believe the media, who simply repeats that all these enforced police measures are only there for our own protection. People are simply not ready to take on personal responsibility. The lifelong programming that daddy government is responsible to take care of us no matter what is so deeply ingrained in the psyche, and therefore reality and truth simply cannot be allowed in. This created narrative of an invisible enemy is extremely powerful. A few can see that whatever protection daddy government provides, it is in reality our own enslavement. A few of us understand that there's no better way to control than through fear. Most people are so busy in survival that they simply have no energy to look at information and to think. They simply do not think. They want nothing more than to zero out their minds. Another reason why people cannot see the truth is because they're blind to position of privilege. They have never come across injustice in their lives. They believe that governments are elected, the people are caring people, and the laws that are in place are all justified and moral. These many people are so naive that they cannot believe that somebody can lie to them. Nothing has ever happened to them that has shaken their trust in the system. For some, even if something very unjust has happened to a loved one, they still manage to find an explanation to justify this injustice because facing the truth is simply an impossibility for them. Finally, most people are so heavily brainwashed to believe in the state that they simply cannot see the truth. Statism is when people take whatever the state or government does to their heart. It is almost like worship. If you insult their government, this nameless, faceless God, you are in fact insulting them. They cannot possibly consider that the president is in fact a puppet for a cult of power. These beliefs are blocking the ability of the great majority of people to see the truth. In my opinion, homeless people are more capable of seeing the truth than highly spiritual people because they are just so completely wrapped up in their belief of spiritual superiority. Spiritual ego is, in fact, the most dangerous one of all the egos. I experienced this ego control, yet I was lucky because I learned about the spiritual ego through Gi and personal Kreshia and was then able to identify it within me and then get rid of it. We are sovereign beings, but we have forgotten who we are. Our very nature is under attack. We're being told that not even our bodies are property. We're being threatened with mandatory treatment and vaccination against our free will. We must not give in to this slavery and individually disconnect ourselves from the masses, the white sheeple, who may never be ready to see the truth. We are all created equal, and the most important step is to remember that nobody has authority over me. I am a sovereign being, equal in all respects to every other being. Nobody has the right to rule me unless I give away my right to govern myself to some self-proclaimed external authority. We only need a critical mass of awakened individuals in action. Everybody will not make it to the finish line and be ready for the coming transformation. It is, however, crucial to remember that this evolution of consciousness must be done individually. Nobody can do the work for me. There is no savior. Please go into action now and make the choice between listening to your ego mind and the external authorities or listening to your soul, the internal authority. The coronavirus pandemic is a psychological force that's being used to enslave humanity completely at every possible level through technocracy. Will you choose not to participate or simply acquiesce to total slavery? There's no government solution. We must first remember who we are and then understand what we're doing here on Earth, specifically right now. Please hit the like button, share this information, and join us in this adventure. I wish to be part of creating self-sustainable small communities. I was blessed with time and created this new life outside of the totalitarian control system. I do not have answers for what you need to do, but I wish to share in whatever way I can. If you have any suggestions, please contact me. My contact information is below. Assistance with farmland purchases in Colombia and Ecuador. Agricultural land is a wise investment and still very economical in these countries. Long-term stay at a Colombian farm, 120 USD per week, 420 USD per month. Spanish lesson. Truth Consciousness Workshop at Cascada Café Retiro in English, Spanish, and French. Dental treatment of high quality, up to 75% savings in Colombia, and migraine treatment with NTI dental appliance. Infinite love.